Hey, how's it going? Well, I saw Peter Rabbit a little earlier today, and he was okay. Maybe 3 stars, 2.5 stars out of five. I appreciate that it kept to more of the, it kept a bit to the original kind of story. They kept it taking place mostly in the country. It wasn't one of these movies where it's, hey, the rabbits in New York. It wasn't like that. So that was nice. That was a pleasurable element to it. They were very careful not to put too many references that would only be gotten like this year or something, you know? Any of the references would still be good even 15 years ago. Maybe not any of them, but most of the references were something that probably 15 years from now we could still look back at it and still enjoy it because it's not filled with all this humor that is only funny during that time. There's a certain kind of, there's a word, there's a phrase for that type of reference, that type of humor, but whatever. The animation on it was actually very good. I was surprised at it. I mean, they look like animated stuffed animals. They look like stuffed animals. And then they never really seem like real rabbits at any point, really. But at least they look like something. When they're not moving, they don't look computer animated. So they didn't do the whole bouncy, bouncy animations too much with it. That's one of my complaints about a lot of computer animation, especially when they have characters that are kind of cartoonish in nature. They make them all bouncing all around, and it looks like they're made out of paint blobs that can, like, wobble. Oh, I don't know how else to describe. I mean, and it's not a typical DreamWorks, what's the other main one? The Pixar. Yeah, it wasn't done like those, and I appreciated that element to it. If it had had that bouncy element to it, yeah, it definitely would have been a 2 stars instead of 3. It was all right. If you're looking for something that has a lot of adult humor in it, no, this isn't gonna be for you. I mean, it's James Corden safe. I think he did a fine job doing the voice. I think the voice acting was good. The acting in general I thought was good, but some of the plot got a little muddied by them trying to, like, there's this point when Peter and one of the other characters, I can't remember which name it was, but it's the slower one. There's a point when they do need to go into the city. Was it London or was it another city? Anyway, oh, it's a tour guide, and the tour guide started taking them all over the city, and it was like, yeah, that if there's a time crunch, they're supposed to get there at this time. Oh, let's throw this type of humor in it. And it's just, eh, they could have done without that. That would be more appropriate humor for something that's fully computer animated, right? But there were a number of inconsistencies in the movie, where most people can't hear them talk, and then other points they can. That was kind of an irritant, an inconsistency. But yeah, overall, I'd give it a 3. If you're into watching a kid-friendly movie, yeah, you might want to check it out. It's certainly better than a lot of the other offerings that you find from, like I said, Pixar and DreamWorks. Not that all their stuff is bad, but just, I mean, at least it's not the fucking Minions, right?